Hello, my name is Nithya Narasimhan. I'm a cloud advocate at Microsoft. And today, I want to talk to you about JavaScript Object Notation. There are just four things you need to know, so let's get started. First, I want to set some context for why JSON is useful. It turns out that JavaScript is actually used extensively in web development today, where you have client-server applications. You might also be familiar with its use in Node, where you have many cases where you need to read and write data from the file system. Both communication protocols and file transfer protocols tend to rely on text-based formats for data transfer. This is where JSON comes in. JSON is a lightweight data exchange format that is language independent and user readable. In fact, in the example on the right side, you can look at what a JavaScript object literal, in this case, a book with three properties, title, author, and is available, looks like when it is converted into an equivalent JSON string, shown below in black. Pretty readable, right? So JSON is a language independent format because any modern programming language that supports two kinds of data structures can use JSON. The first is name value pairs. Any programming language that supports the ability to have a collection of name value pairs. And in JavaScript, this is probably very familiar to you. Doesn't that look like an object with properties? The second data structure is an ordered list of values. While name value pairs let you serialize a single object, if you want to pack multiple objects into a single string, you need an array. These two data structures are supported in most modern programming languages. Here's what that looks like when you use it with JavaScript data. So the JSON format effectively is name value pairs for a single object. It encloses name value pairs separated by commas within curly braces as shown in the highlighted yellow. When you have multi-item or complex arrays serialized, it encloses all those multiple objects, again separated by commas, inside square blue brackets. Both of these are very usable, user-readable strings. But how do you convert between JavaScript objects and JSON? Well, you just need to know two methods. First, objects to JavaScript to JSON, you stringify them. That's easy to remember, right? Because you're converting into string formats. What I want you to look at in these two examples, the first one serializes a JavaScript object into a single text string. The second serializes a collection of JavaScript objects into a text string, which represents an ordered list. What I want you to pay attention to is both of these use the exact same method, JSON.stringify, and pass in a reference to the data that you want serialized, whether it's an object or an array. You don't need to have any kind of difference between them. Once you've stringified it, how do you then deserialize or restore the original objects from that? Well, just remember JSON.parse. So again, if you have a serialized string, you don't even need to know whether that came from an object or a collection. Simply pass it to JSON.parse and it'll return your reference to a JavaScript object or possibly an array. Using typeof with that returned result will let you know the difference between the two. But what I want you to kind of look at here is that the JSON that the JSON string, once deserialized, gives you an object that's effectively got the properties restored. What if you needed to have the object define the functions as well? JSON's not going to do that for you. The best way to do that is to have a constructor that's capable of taking the properties and its data that's serialized and then restoring it to a complete object with the functions defined as well using a custom constructor. With that, that's literally all you needed to know about JSON. So hopefully you got to understand what JSON is, what the JSON format looks like, how to convert JavaScript objects to JSON, and how to restore a JavaScript object from a JSON string. Hope that was fun. See you at the next module.